History. I'm from a lovely little town called Padiham. I went to Padiham Green Primary School and I loved it so much that my daughter goes there now. For high school, I went to St Christopher's. Alright, I get it. But I was deputy head boy. From there, it was A levels in theatre studies, performing arts and media studies at St Mary's College, Blackburn. At this point in my life, I made an outstanding decision and I chose Aberystwyth University for my degree. So in 2003, I decided to study a BA in Theatre, Film and Television at Aberystwyth University, and I still believe it's probably the best decision I've ever made. I wasn't even going to Aberystwyth, I went on an open day on a whim and just fell in love with it on arrival, and I think that's really important. Go and visit universities, see where you can visualise yourself spending 3 years of your life. I learned so much in my time at university and it really helped me to focus my mind on who I wanted to be. I met some incredible friends who I still stay in contact with now, and I really got an understanding of what I wanted to specialise in life. And there I am at my 13-year graduation reunion with my close friends. So in my late teens and early 20s, I had a couple of opportunities to spend time in Central America, in Nicaragua. I've got family who live out there. So I spent about 12 weeks over 2 summers exploring the country. And while I was there, I volunteered as a sort of a teaching assistant at a school for teenagers and young adults who wanted to learn English as a second language. What I really saw was how education can inspire people and how these young people were using education to push themselves out of poverty and into a brighter future. I met some amazing people with some incredible stories to tell, and the more time I spent with them in this world away from Lancashire, the more I thought teaching could be for me. This is something that I can really see myself doing for a career. So that was it. When I came back from Nicaragua the second time, I just became really focused on the fact that, you know, I want to be a teacher. I want to do that. So once I'd finished my degree, I enrolled on a PGC course through UCLan, and I studied that over 2 years whilst working full time. And when I qualified as a teacher, I then landed a role as a lecturer at Accrington College, and I stayed there for 5 years teaching performing arts and media, from level one right up to foundation degree. But after that time, I kind of felt like I needed a change, and I realised that working as part of a kind of big machine of a college was not necessarily where I was most comfortable, and I wanted to work somewhere with a kind of smaller, more community family feel. And that's when I made a really odd decision to go back to St. Christopher's after leaving as a pupil and saying I'm never going there ever again, never. So actually thinking this could be somewhere that feels like home professionally. So I had an opportunity, I went back and I stayed for 7.5 years, and really enjoyed my time there. Did kind of a variety of different teaching, but what was most fulfilling was my teaching within the special needs sixth form provision. Teaching BTEC Media to a group of young people with a range of disabilities and learning issues, and that really made me into a better teacher. And then at the end of last year, there was an opportunity to make a change and move to Accrington Academy, and that's what I did, and it has been the best professional decision I've ever made. I could not be happier.
Right, so key bit of advice to finish with. Do what is going to make you happy. Make the decisions that are best for you. It's really easy when you're a teenager to feel like you're pressured to do what your friends want to do what your parents want you to do what we as your teachers think you should do. But what you should really do, I think, is to take all that advice on board, listen to those opinions, but then make the decision that's right for you. Visit as many universities or apprenticeship placements or employers as you can. Get to know about them. Really figure out, is this something that I can see devoting the rest of my life to? You might not know specifically what the job will be, but that area. So for me, theatre, film and television is something that's been a constant in my life since I was very, very small. And I knew that any career that I could forge within that area would make me happy, would keep me fulfilled professionally and personally, and would kind of tick all those creative boxes that I know I need to tick to be happy. So really, the final piece of advice I want to give you, and it really does link to that, is make the right choice, but then work hard. Work harder than anybody else to get what you're trying to get. Make sure that nobody looks at you and thinks you're just coasting through life. Go after it. If there's something you want, chase it down. Make it happen, because when you reach degree level or apprenticeship or employment, nobody's going to be doing it for you. It's all on you. Work for it. Finally, I let my wife give me a quarantine haircut. What do you reckon? Not done bad, eh? Savage undercut, though. What are you going to do?